You've probably seen people talking about the Succinct Testnet and already made some posts about this project. So here's a complete guide on how to join, earn, and make the most of it. Succinct is building a decentralized zk-proving network, and its testnet is where you can start contributing before the mainnet launch. First of all, you're gonna need a code to start. Check my previous post on how to get it. And here's a quick tip. You need to earn it by completing tasks on Discord, being an active community member, or creating content. Once you got it, remember, you're gonna need to deposit 10 USDC to start with the testnet. Head to the dashboard, click on deposit, and follow the instructions. You can deposit only once. Then every Tuesday, the team recharges your balance so you can play more and earn more stars. I recommend checking out the whole platform to get a better understanding of what Succinct is about. By clicking on Vision, you'll find an FAQ and a roadmap. As you can see, we are still on stage 1, but there will be another stage of the testnet called Prove With Us before the mainnet launch. Now let's move on. Our main goal here is to earn stars, and you can do this by playing games. But to actually get the stars, you need to lock in your highest score. Here's how it works. When you lock in, some USDC is deducted from your balance, but in return, you earn stars, which you'll claim later. We'll get to that soon. You'll see your balance in the top right corner, and the key is to spend it all to maximize your earnings. To do that, click on Earn, then Games. You will see all the available games here, or you can just explore all games on the dock below. The team adds new games almost every Tuesday, along with the balance recharge. Now let's talk about the games. So let's start with the first one, Super Prover World. This one is super easy. You just click on one of these question marks. So basically you select a program to prove randomly. The size of the program determines how many stars you're gonna get. Larger ones gives you more. It usually takes just a few cents and gives you a one star. Next game, Ethereum Last Block. The max cost here is 5 USDC. All you need to do is follow the instructions, enter a number from 1 to 5 to select a block to prove. Larger blocks require more computation, but they also give you more stars. You can also just repeat these full 5 blocks and earn some extra stars. The next one is Floppy. Now it's getting even more fun. You start playing the well-known game Floppy Bird. If you are good at it, it's gonna be easy for you. After you play, you need to log in to generate a proof of your verified score. Your USDC balance will be deducted and you'll get some stars in return. The good thing is, you can log in only your best scores to get more stars. Once you believe you reached your highest score, click Prove and just wait. You can log in as many times as you want. The higher your score, the more stars you get. But let's explore more games. Next we have Truthlands. You're given 10 pictures and you need to spot the fake ones. Basically select the pictures you think are fake, click submit and then check your result. Each week new pictures are added, so there are always something fresh to test your skills. Now let's move on to Turbo Racing. This one is super easy. Just use the left and right arrow keys to move, collect chips and avoid bricks. Let's just take a moment to appreciate how satisfying it is to watch this. Lock in higher scores to get more stars. You can also unlock some vehicles when you reach a certain score. So lock in and let's move. The next game is Very Star. It's a quiz and there's a new one each week. Basically, you need to read the info before the quiz. You have 4 cards and 4 questions. Study them carefully and try to get all the questions right. So here you can learn and test your knowledge about decay proof while earning stars. Okay, let's move on to a game I'm sure you already know, 2048. Just play and lock in your score. A tip from me, you should only move in 3 directions. For example, go right, left and up, but never go down. Keep your higher number in the top corner. Last week, I actually won this game because once you reached 2048, the game was over and you won. But now the game doesn't stop at 2048. You can keep going, score even higher, and earn more stars. And finally, the last game, which was added a few days ago, this Tuesday, Ferris Volleyball. There are three options: easy, medium, and hard. Choose the one you prefer and play. I haven't tried this one very well yet, but the rules are the same. The more score you get, the more stars you earn. And remember, the most important thing is to always lock in on your higher scores. Once you've spent all your balance, head back to your dashboard, you'll see how many stars you earned. Click claim stars and hope for a good multiplier to get even more. One time I got a super high multiplier, and instead of getting 200 stars, I got almost 2000. That's a huge boost to your position on the leaderboard. On your dashboard, you can also see the total number of stars you have, the number of generated proofs, and the number of cycles. Let me quickly explain what this is. The proof mechanism is a system where you, as a user, send a request to be proven, and provers are assigned to handle it. You can check the details in the Explorer. Each request has a fee, the one you pay when you log in, a cycle count, how much work is needed, and a deadline, how long the user is willing to wait. Provers have limits on how much work they can do and private costs for each unit of work. This system ensures requests are assigned efficiently to balance cost, speed, and decentralization. Now back to the dashboard. Scroll down to see the leaderboard, where you can find the top 10 players with the most stars. You can also click on see all to get a better understanding on how much other users have. And that's basically it. But don't stop there, there's so much more to explore in this testnet. The design is super cool, it's given 2000 swipes. I recommend checking out what's on the desktop, turn on some music, watch videos about Succinct, read the white paper, and browse through all available folders. You never know what's waiting for you there. If you don't have a code yet, don't worry, you can still play some games like 2048, Turbo Racing, and Volleyball without one. But of course, you should focus on getting that code and start earning stars. Now you know how to get started, time to get in and prove yourself. Good luck, and let me know in the comments if you have any questions.